We have heard it from such a young age. Go to school, get good grades, go to college. When we started high school, we filled out a sheet of paper with what career we think we wanted, and then we picked our classes according to our career. Mine was backwards. For some reason, I picked my classes and then I picked my career. The counselor seemed to agree with my class selection. College prep classes with some ag classes mixed in as well. But when I wrote down military as my career, she seemed puzzled. Why would he want these college prep classes for a career in the military, where all you have to do to get in is graduate? I'm so tired of people talking down the military as an option after high school, often referring to it as the other option, as if it was a last resort, that it's just filled with low-life scumbags whose greatest accomplishment is just graduating high school. I'm not going to say that there aren't these kinds of people in the military, because there are, but look around, they're everywhere anymore. Sure, there are some that come in and go out of the military that way, but most that come in that way are changed into a good, upstanding member of a society. I know a guy named David. He grew up in kind of a rough house, so he wasn't the greatest kid. He tried really hard in school and was able to graduate ahead of his high school class. But after high school, his rough side kind of caught up with him, and he started to go down the wrong path. He eventually was met with an ultimatum. Continue down this road, which is leading to jail, or you can go into the military. He ended up enlisting in the Marines. He applied himself and through hard work made it into a recon platoon, one of the most elite units in the US military. Then, by applying his intelligence side, he became a nuclear, biological, and chemical warfare specialist. You talk to people that knew him before and after he went into the Marines, and they'll tell you it's amazing what the military did for him. People often ask me, why did you join the military? For me, the most significant motivation was honor. In my mind, there is nothing more honorable than military service. Some may ask what honor is. Sleeping in a hole, somewhere far, far away from home, defending the American dream? Now that's honor. To go out every day and try to help oppressed people achieve a more fruitful, happier life? To be a trusted member of a team that all has each other's backs? And being willing to serve your country and put your life on the line to protect its well-being? Now that's honor. Some people may say, well, what if you die? Is it still worth it? Yes, in my opinion, we are all going to die, so if it's my fate to die while protecting my country and my brothers beside me, then so be it. As Niles Harris, a Vietnam vet, once said, caught in the action of killed or be killed, greater love have no man than to lay down his life for a friend. A flag draped over a coffin and a 21-gun salute is a sign of ultimate sacrifice, and nothing is more honorable than that. For some, getting their dream job or a college degree is a high-valued honor, but for me, the only way to earn this level of honor is to take the oath of enlistment and serve with your brothers in arms. You will live, fight, and may even die together, and you will always have each other's backs. As a Marine Corps says, semper fidelis, or always faithful. That is honor. This I believe.